As we have done in other valuation exercises before, let's start filling the information in the market value balance sheet of Whole Foods. As shown here, on the asset side, we have the value of operations or enterprise value and the value of non-operating assets. On the liability side, we have equity and debt. Recall that our goal is to obtain the market value of equity, which after all is what Amazon is buying. To do this, we will need the value of the other three boxes: operating assets, non-operating assets, and debt. We can obtain the value of non-operating assets and the book value of debt, which we use to approximate its market value, from the accounting balance sheet. This is Whole Foods' accounting balance sheet as of July 2, 2017. By the way, this balance sheet was obtained from what is called a 10Q report that publicly listed firms are required to file with the Security and Exchange Commission. We see that the only non-operating asset is cash and short-term equivalents with a value of 1,123 million. In terms of debt, Whole Foods has long-term debt. 2 million of this debt is due within 1 year and is listed as long-term debt current portion. And 1,046 million is due beyond 1 year and is listed as long-term debt non-current portion. The total amount of debt is therefore 1,048 million. We can now place these two values into our market value balance sheet. Now, we turn to the more difficult part of the valuation, the estimation of the value of operation or the enterprise value. Recall that to find this value, we need to discount the free cash flows at the weighted average cost of capital. Let's turn first to the free cash flows.